The previous video I did was really short, like a minute long, where all I did was show that there's a Raspberry Pi and it can drive a Vive. But I figured it would make sense to make a second video, a little bit longer. Still not my normal, like, crazy production, but just something that explains what's really going on here. So, the idea is that the Raspberry Pi is straight up hooked up to the Vive here, and, like, it is tracking as you'd expect, kind of doing the sorts of things you'd expect a Vive to do. And, like, I can move stuff around inside the VR environment and shoot things. So this is a really lo-fi game. You can see most of the things are wire mesh, though not all of them. I'm really surprised by just how many vertices the Raspberry Pi can handle. And the fact that it can just straight up run Live Survive without really any issues at all. Like, I'm like looking around the room right now and everything seems to be lining up pretty good. One of the biggest problems that I had, though, was that I would need a way of showing everybody else what's going on. And that's what I'm really doing with the Spreadgine. Ooh, that's a little bit glitchy. Still not perfect. The tracking is still... Oh, it's probably because it was covering so many dots. But the idea is that I can, like, move around and... By having the Raspberry Pi serve a web page, and instead of actually transferring the video that's coming off of the Raspberry Pi GPU, which would be totally like outside of the scope of what the Raspberry Pi could do, instead I can just send high-level kind of OpenGL commands to the web browsers to what's going on. And that way, like this right here, it's actually all of this video here is being transferred without a lot of space. So in the little stats block up here, you can see that it says that each one of these frames is only 100 kilobytes, rather than however large it would normally take to transfer these sorts of video frames. So that was kind of a fun thing right there. Another one was, well, I guess actually another kind of interesting bit is the power supply. You've noticed that I am right now powering it up to like 6.7 volts. And there is a little bit of resistance in my wires, but the thing I still don't quite understand is, like, if I look through here, okay, let's see if I can... actually, there's really no good way to orient this to show you guys in detail, but I could shoot a lot more of the bullets here. Oof. Let's see here. So, yeah. Put this over there, and then you can kind of have something you can see. If I lower the voltage on this, so like lower, at some point, like probably around 5 volts, yeah, it just starts glitching out. So even at 5.5 volts, the video on the screen is pretty badly glitched. Now, the Raspberry Pi is still running just fine, but it just cannot output to the Vive, and I'm not really sure why. When you up the voltage back, it starts to work. Now, under heavy load, like, it seems to glitch out at higher voltages, so that's why I'm running it around 6.7 volts. I did not know that that was safe, but apparently it is, so that's what I'm doing. The other one is the Raspberry Pi itself overheats a great deal when operating these sorts of things, so I'm actually working on a kind of a hat for the Raspberry Pi. So this is the one for the Orange Pi I did, but I'm working on a new one for the Raspberry Pi so that I can have kind of a hat that can have the fan mounted right into it along with a power supply. So the idea here is the Raspberry Pi would actually be able to be self-contained with the headset, just like I did with my Orange Pi video. But one of the biggest conveniences of the Raspberry Pi is that it has much, much better software support and way fewer bugs as far as the 3D systems are concerned. So that's a lot of fun. Not really sure what else to really point out here. Yeah, I've been having a lot of fun with this project, and it really has been kind of a good way to thoroughly test out Live Survive and make sure that things are working as, you know, as I would need in order to make a sort of video game. So just so you guys can see, actually, I guess I should show what the video game is. Have this kind of mounted in the Vive here. And I can take a gun, see the gun up in front of me? And I can shoot these, it's kind of like bad video, but I can shoot the square boxes, and yeah. Actually, there's gotta be more square boxes. Oh, there's one. So yeah, that's the kind of limited video game I'm toying with right here. Okay, I hope you guys thought that this video was kind of interesting and fun, just showing some progress. Hopefully I'll be able to get this into something that's a lot cooler, and maybe at some point I could even have a Vive stream where I use the Raspberry Pi and live stream basically from the environment within VR. Enjoy!